Good afternoon, and welcome to our 2020 Dodgeland graduation ceremony, whether you are here in person or joining us online. As you all know, this is a more unique graduation ceremony than any previous year, with only two guests per graduate and the ceremony being live streamed online, which will also be available to view after the ceremony. I have to thank our incredible tech department, Brad Modaff and Josh Jornes, for making this possible today. We have not had a full rehearsal with our graduates, so please bear with us as I will be giving directions throughout the ceremony. We are so excited to have our graduates in person here today, knowing that many other seniors did not get this opportunity due to the pandemic. We thank you for your cooperation with the social distancing limitations that were placed upon us. As our graduates enter the gymnasium for the start of the ceremony, you are welcome to take pictures. However, please remain at your seats so we can maintain social distancing. At this time, I would like to welcome the processional of the Dodgeland Class of 2020, led by our junior honor guards, Evan Finger and Abby Petches. Would everyone please rise for the playing of our national anthem?
Thank you.
Please be seated. On behalf of the Class of 2020, the Dodgeland Board of Education, administration, teachers, and faculty, I want to welcome you all to the Class of 2020 Dodgeland graduation ceremony. When we left school at the end of the day on Friday, March 13th, we had no idea that students would not be walking our halls again for the remainder of the school year. Who would have ever thought that Friday the 13th would be the date of our last normal day together? We also never would have guessed that we would be having graduation on July 25th. Nothing about the last few months has been normal, and it has tested us each in different ways. The Dodgeland administration wants to thank our families, students, and faculty for your willingness to adapt to the changes as best we could. We also want to thank you for your patience as we planned graduation to try to make it as memorable for you as it could be, despite the limitations that we had to work with. Graduation marks a milestone in your lives. As you begin this new journey, it is important to thank those people that helped you get here today. Your parents, your family members, your friends, and your teachers. Seniors, please join me in a round of applause for these special people in your lives, whether they are here or watching online. While I have only been the high school principal for this past year, I've been fortunate to know most of you from the time you were first graders at Dodgeland Elementary, and I am so proud of all that each of you have accomplished and the growth that you have made in your K-12 journey. I am so honored to be able to celebrate this day with you in person today. Life is full of challenges, and every single one of those challenges helps build you as an individual. Every obstacle you overcome helps build resilience, and you have definitely had to practice resiliency skills in your senior year that no other senior class has had to do. Take the lessons you've learned during your time here and use them to guide you through your lives. This day is not an end, but simply a beginning. As one small door in your life is closing, another very large door is opening to a much bigger world for you. At this time, I would like to introduce Mrs. Amanda Bodo, our business education teacher. Mrs. Bodo was voted on by the senior class to be chosen as the faculty speaker for our ceremony.
Congratulations to you, the class of 2020. This is the moment that you've all waited for a very long time, and I do mean a very long time. Thank you for the honor of allowing me to address your class one final time. Back in September, when you were all dreaming of this day, I'm sure this is not what you had imagined. But I figure if we're going to do things different, then let's really mix this up and make this stage my classroom for the next 42 minutes. I want to teach one more time. I'm just kidding. Mrs. Johnson wouldn't let me talk that long, I asked. But I do have one final lesson for you I want to share with you before you complete your dive into adulthood. Allow me to tell you a little story. The year is 1999, and I'm a junior in high school. My mom is working for the telephone company, those things we had before the cell phones. Well, she needed to take a trip out of state to learn some new technologies for the company and needed a ride to the airport. And so I gave her a ride to the airport, and it was my first time ever being in an airport. I was floored. For those of you that have flown, you know the airport is more than just a bunch of chairs. It's like a mall in there. There are restaurants, coffee shops, bookstores, souvenir shops. I gotta tell you, I was blown away. I had no idea there was a whole world inside the airport. I thought it was just a bunch of chairs while people waited for flights. So we get to the airport and we quickly walk through the scanners with our shoes on. And we grab a cup of coffee. My mom and I sit down and watch the planes come and go for a few moments until her boarding group is called. Once her boarding group is called, she goes onto the plane. I stand around and watch her plane take off because, like I said, first time there, I was kind of excited. And then I head home. Now, some of you who have flown are thinking right now, wait a second, how did you get all the way to the gate without a ticket? Where were the long lines and security checks? And all of you are thinking, what the heck does your trip 20 years ago to the airport have anything to do with my graduation today? Well, just hang with me. I'm going to get there. Now let's fast forward to 2001. I was a freshman at the University of Wisconsin-Whitewater, just rolling out of bed, and my phone rings. It's my brother calling, and my brother never called. And so I answer the phone a little bit panicked, and he says the words that I'll never forget. Turn on your TV, we're being attacked. And in that moment, on September 11th, 2001, our world changed. The United States and Canadian airspace closed for 2 days. The New York Stock Exchange closed for 4 days as the country tried to come to grips with what had happened. Over the next few years, we saw massive changes in the ways we operate with large crowds. We increased security at airports, and now you needed a ticket to get to the gate. Even at sporting events, we began to search bags. And as this country went through these massive changes, at the same time, your parents were preparing for a change of their own. Over the next 2 years, your parents welcomed the class of 2020 into the world. In the midst of pain and fear that our country was dealing with, your parents welcomed you into the world with joy and love. Just as the airports would never be the same for travelers, your parents' lives would never be the same. You were born into a rapidly changing world, and now you enter into a world that was inconceivable just a few months ago. Over the past 4 months, COVID-19, or coronavirus, has changed the way we learn, the way we work, the way we shop, and the way we celebrate, just as 9/11 changed the way we travel, enter sporting events, and attend concerts. But here's the thing about major changes like these. We have a choice in how we react. In 2001, our country was rocked by the events of September 11th. As citizens of a country under attack by an unknown enemy, we could have chosen to hide and be scared or lash out in anger. And while those emotions existed, we also came together as a country. We wept with New York City. We remembered our fallen brothers and sisters, and we came together to support each other. Once again, we stand in the midst of change. As you begin your dive into adulthood, the country around you is changing. You are living in a time of a health pandemic, social unrest, and political divisiveness. You have a choice. You have a choice in how you enter your adult life. You can be sad for missing the major milestones of your senior year. You can be angry that you did not get the graduation that you wanted. Or you can run into the storm and create a better world on the other side. Your class, your generation, has the ability to affect change. Over the past 4 years, I have been a firsthand witness to your class embracing your world and seeking to make it better. I saw you develop community service projects that help the Gathering Source and the Humane Society. I saw you organize blood drives and raffles. I saw you encourage friends, classmates, and even your teachers when time was tough. I have watched you excel at sports and academic pursuits. I have seen you make mistakes and then bounce back to be better and stronger. I have watched you grow from awkward, giggly freshmen to confident and capable adults. And because of what I have seen, I know that each and every one of you is prepared to change our world. Steve Jobs, one of the co-founders of Apple, once said, "The people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do." Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. Your class, your generation, is the future. In this unparalleled time of change and uncertainty, you can choose your reaction. Make the choice to think for yourself. Become the loving, caring adults that I know you can be. You can choose to embrace this change with love and compassion for others, as I have seen you do in the past. You can choose to think of others above yourself. You can change this world for the better. You can push out the voices around you and listen to the goodness in your heart that I know is there, and then use that voice to change our country and our world for the better. And so this is my final lesson to you as your teacher. Use the tools and knowledge that you have gained these past 18 years to face this rapidly changing world with love and compassion. I know that you are crazy enough to change the world. Congratulations again, and welcome to adulthood.
Thank you, Mrs. Bodo. The Class of 2020 salutatorian, Caitlin Pickert, will provide the class welcome and salutatorian address. Caitlin is also receiving the salutatorian award.
Welcome to the graduation of Dodgeland's High School Class of 2020. 2020 has definitely been a year for the history books. I'm sure none of us could have predicted that we would be holding a graduation ceremony in July, much less with a spread out audience and mass graduates. But here we are, and I'm so glad to be here. Before I begin, I want to thank everyone who has made this ceremony possible. Thank you to the administration team, the Dodgeland staff, the parents, and the community for finding a way to celebrate this milestone in our lives and for organizing our graduation ceremony. But there are more thank yous needed than that. Thank you to the coaches, advisors, teachers, parents, grandparents, siblings, and friends who have been our biggest supporters during our time at Dodgeland. Without you, we wouldn't be who we are today, nor have the wonderful memories of our time here. You lifted us up when we were down and inspired us to work tirelessly toward our goals. You have provided guidance when we were unsure and given us incredible opportunities for growth, whether that be through trying something totally new, joining a club, participating in athletics, traveling to Germany or Mexico with the foreign language department, having real-life conversations with teachers, or taking on a leadership position for any of the clubs here at Dodgeland. We have so much to be grateful for, and much of it wouldn't be possible without everyone here at Dodgeland. So thank you. My time at Dodgeland has been full of amazing memories. From homecoming freshman year to academic decathlon this spring, I've been able to experience so much. Conferences, competitions, and school dances, state competitions for both athletics and academics, a trip to Germany last spring, and of course, all of the time spent in this building. Whether it be laughing over lunch or rolling your eyes at another essay due soon, we have made so many memories here. All of these things required rising to the challenge of stepping outside my comfort zone and giving a speech, or flying in a plane for the first time, or running against really great competition at the state meet. They all required me to put aside any doubts or fears I had about what I was faced with and step up. Rising to the occasion can be scary and uncertain, but it forces you to grow as a person, which is something we should all strive for. Always showing up and giving it your all, especially when you don't want to or you're afraid to, is something that is so important for not only the task at hand, but for all the challenges life will throw at you. Right now, as we leave high school and have the freedom to choose our next steps, is the perfect time to start showing up for yourself, your goals, your dreams, and your future. As Thomas Edison said, many of life's failures are people who do not realize how close they are to success when they gave up. So do not give up on your dreams. Rise to the challenges they present. Do not let uncertainty about the future scare you away from doing what you've always wanted to do. The class of 2020 has faced many things that other classes and generations have not. We have grown up surrounded by uncertainty and changing times. We were born into a world still in shock from the horrors terrorism had brought so close to home. We were raised alongside the rise of technology and have seen the effects lightning-quick social media reactions have had on our society. And now, as we enter adulthood, we have experienced the immediate reactions to a global pandemic. It's safe to say we've grown up fast. The world will continue to change, and we will continue to be faced with challenges in our personal lives, our workplaces, and our country. I know that we are each destined to do great things, to make an impact in the world. Whether that be through the military, a career in the trades, the result of earning a university degree, or using your skills in entering the workforce, continue to rise up and meet the things that scare you, challenge you, and intimidate you. Think about the person you want to be and the things you want to do in this life, and start working to make those dreams your reality. After all, you're the only one who can. Thank you.
Thank you, Caitlin. The Class of 2020 valedictorian, Josephine Shaw, will give the valedictorian address. Josephine is also receiving the valedictorian award.
Class of 2020. As I struggled for the past month to prepare this speech, I knew it would be impossible not to address the reason this ceremony is far from what we imagined. With that said, I could talk about the cancellation of activities and events we had looked forward to for years, or about the positive character building we've all endured at the hands of this shared struggle. But in doing so, I would feel insincere in not expressing what's really been on my mind, and I'm sure some of yours as well. For that reason, I think it's worthwhile to discuss a darker truth revealed by reactions to both the COVID-19 pandemic and the Black Lives Matter movement. That is, the unfortunately common, willful ignorance and unwillingness to change that prioritizes comfort and a false sense of normalcy over human lives. It's disconcerting, to say the least, that we are graduating into a world where a prevalent attitude is to deny the existence of problems rather than to acknowledge and solve them. Fortunately, I find hope in reflecting on the accomplishments of you, fellow members of the Dodgeland Class of 2020. As members of extracurriculars, you've demonstrated your compassion and willingness to serve just causes. You've volunteered at blood drives, organized collections for the Humane Society, planned food and clothing drives, and donated your time, creativity, and work ethic to countless other service projects in the last 4 years. As students, you've passionately defended your ideals in class discussions and debates and maintained open minds to the opinions of those around you. Last year outside the classroom, many of you helped organize the movement here at Dodgeland that resulted in the updated dress code. You saw a problem and worked together to fix it, and your call for change was heard. I recently read a Facebook post by an adult in the Dodgeland community claiming that our generation is mouthy. While this appeared in a negative context, I take pride in the fact that we are making our voices heard. Furthermore, it motivates me to thank the parents and family members who do encourage us to be outspoken. However, we especially owe our ability to effectively voice and defend our ideas to the educators who have taught, supported, challenged, and most importantly, inspired us. Poet W.B. Yeats said, "Education is not the filling of a pail, but the lighting of a fire." And I thank Dodgeland educators for using their passion to light fires within each of us. No matter how bleak the world seems, I maintain the hope that each of you will continue to use your unique skills, passions, and voices to make the world a better place. I cannot wait to see what you all will do next. Thank you, and good luck.
Thank you, Josephine. At this time, I present the Class of 2020 to District Administrator Dr. Annette Van Hook Thompson and the Dodgeland Board of Education. Each student has met the requirements of the Wisconsin Department of Public Instruction as well as the Dodgeland Board of Education for high school graduation. Calling the class roll will be Associate Principal and Athletic Director Mrs. Marcia Modaff. Presenting diplomas will be Dodgeland School Board members Mr. Jeffrey Kane and Mrs. Serene Seitzer. Presenting the graduates their class flower will be the Junior Honor Guards Evan Finger and Abby Petches. Seniors, everyone up here who will be congratulating you today wants you to know that they're smiling under the masks when you come through. I also want to inform you that Mrs. Modaff will be announcing the name of every 2020 graduate, including those who could not be with us here in person today, because we know they and their families are watching online. Parents and honored guests, we ask that you remain at your seats as diplomas are awarded. Seniors, please watch to your right, where Mr. Minshaw will be motioning you to move forward when it is time for your row and to continue to remain socially distanced. But most importantly, what your parents want, please make sure that when you are handed your diploma, that you stop and you look to that camera so that Ms. Lee can take your picture. That picture will be emailed out to you and your parents. After you walk off the stage, you will walk around the gymnasium to the back corner where a Life Touch photographer will take your photo, and then you will continue around the gym and return to your seats.
Josephine Jean Shawl. Caitlin Rebecca Pickard. Timothy John Anderson. Zoe Lynn Andrews. Connor Allen Arndt. Brianna Magdalena Bacon. Ty Christopher Bader. Bethany Rose Ballas. Megan Ann Bartlett.
Wait. Thank you. Go ahead to the step.
Bryce Charles Brosh. Okay. Callie Jean Berger. Alyssa Marie Buskey. Grace Mary Jane Kane. Samuel Cole Camilla. Seth Alfred Christofferson. Zachariah Juan Carlos Council. Cody Jacob Coparis. Samuel Stephen Cox. Blake Andrew Durge. Josie Marie Rose Dobratz. Tatum Elizabeth Earl. Amanda Rose Egebrecht. Angelina Elizabeth Emmerich. Caitlin Ray Fawcett. Janelle Lauren Feckler. Nathaniel Russell Gibbs. Courtney Rose Goldbach. Cole Michael Gunther. Naomi Rose Hadley. Seth Michael Hayden. Trinity Lynn Hill. Brenton Dean Hofer. Cody M. Horner. Allison Marie Huber. Bailey Brianna Hebner. Kiera Lynn Ivins. Alan Earl Juno. Caitlin Rose Cone. Trey Sebastian Krieger. Hayden Philip Kurth. Allison Jean Manthe. Mackenzie K. Marquardt. Alexandra Irene Maurer Ireland. Isabella Angelie Michelinus. Spencer Joseph Eddie Morris. Selena Cheyenne Noble. Nathan William Astrike. Rachel May Parbs. Alan Michael Perrell. Gregory Joseph Plain. Dylan Michael Potius. Alexander Michael Ron. Molly May Ryder. Autumn Rose Renock. Brock Milton Roy. Christian Otto Schall. Emily Ann Schmidt. Jayani Lisa Diane Sparkman. Elizabeth Maria Stotts. Dylan Mark Stofflett. Caitlin Rose Lynn Strife. Joshua Martin Stubbe. Brody Nathan Tasker. Tice Andrew Vandenberg. Carrie Ann Westfall. Joshua Ethan White. Miranda Christina Renee Zavachin.
At this time, I would like to introduce Selena Noble, class president, to announce the senior gift and lead her final duty.
On behalf of the class of 2020, I would like to announce that we want the remaining balance in our class account in the amount of $580 to go for masks and hand sanitizers for students this year. And now it is time for us to move the tassel. Fellow graduates, please stand with me in a moment as we move our tassels from right to the left side to signify that we have now officially graduated from high school.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege and pleasure to introduce the newest class, alumni class of Dodgeland High School, the class of 2020. Parents and honored guests, we ask that you remain at your seats until all of our graduates have made it out of the gym. We will have a faculty member serving as an usher to dismiss each row of guests out of the gymnasium, so we remain socially distanced, and thank you for your cooperation. You can meet your graduate in the parking lot to line up for the parade that has been planned by parents.
Was staring out the window of their SUV, complaining, saying, I can't wait to turn 18. She said, I'll make my own money and I'll make my own rules. Mama put the car in park out there in front of the school, and she kissed her head and said, I was just like you. You're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this. She knows it, she's a brand new bride in her one bedroom apartment, and her daddy stops by. He tells her it's a nice place, she says it'll do for now. Starts talking about babies and buying a house. Daddy shakes his head and says, baby, just slow down. Cause you're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this. He says, they don't bother me. I've got two babies of my own. One's 36, one's 23. It's hard to believe, but you're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look. Yeah.